wanna see. We wanna see. We wanna see Jesus lifted up.
Good morning, family, and a warm welcome to the fifth Sunday in Lent. How time has flown just past. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We want to see Jesus lifted high, a banner that flies across this land, that all men might see the truth and know He is the way to heaven. We want to see Jesus lifted high, a banner that flies across this land, that all men might see the truth and know He is the way to heaven. We want to see, we want to see, we want to see Jesus lifted high. We want to see, we want to see, we want to see Jesus lifted high. Step by step we're moving forward, little by little taking ground. Every prayer a powerful weapon, strongholds come tumbling down and down and down and down. We want to see, we want to see, we want to see Jesus lifted high. We want to see, we want to see, we want to see Jesus lifted high. We want to see, we want to see, we want to see Jesus lifted high. We want to see, we want to see, we want to see Jesus lifted high.
Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Jesus said, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets." And so let us confess our sins, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with our neighbor. Gracious and patient God, we come before you with so many things which weigh us down. Forgive us, God, for all those things which we have neglected to do that would have helped someone else to be closer to you. Heal our hearts from the wounds which have been inflicted upon us by the anger and misunderstandings which occur in relationships. Prepare our lives to be of service to you. In silence we wait. We long for your presence and your healing touch. Amen.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on us, pardon our sins, and set us free from them. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us pray the collect together. God of suffering and glory, in Jesus Christ you reveal the way of life. Inscribe your law on our hearts, that we may not stray from you, but remain your faithful people. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Listen to the good news as it is written in the Gospel of John, chapter 12, beginning at verse 20. Glory to Christ our Saviour. Some Greeks wished to see Jesus. Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honour. And now my soul is troubled. And what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name." Then a voice came from heaven. "I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again." The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, "An angel has spoken to him." And Jesus answered, "This voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself." He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. This is the Gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord.
May I speak in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. As you remember from this past Sunday, we were reminded how it is that we find ourselves in snaky places. And in those places, we find ourselves quite uncomfortable because it's not just but one snake, it's a whole lot happening around you at the same time. So even if you were comfortable with reptiles, these ones seem to be too many, and they're invading your privacy. You didn't ask to have fun time with them. And so these are the kind of things that come to us as people. What then happens to us is we seek reprieve from whatever it is that we're experiencing, whether it is happening to the physical body as pain, it's happening in our minds, it's happening in the lives of the people around us, it's happening in our community, in our country, it is things we don't like, it is things we are not comfortable with, or it's things we wish for but we are not getting. It becomes particularly confusing and uncomfortable. For others, we tend to lash out. For some, we look within and we exclude everybody. But today's story does something that I'm hoping that from us who lead the communities of worship to everybody who believes themselves to be a Christian will follow. We are told that among those that went to worship on this particular day, there was a group of Greeks. And it appears as if they arrived somewhat late, because everybody else was there and there must have been a crowd. And so, the hierarchy kicked in. They must have known Jesus' disciples. So they went to Philip. But I want us to really, really look at what they said. They went to him and said, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." They were clear about what they wanted. We know Jesus' disciples could perform miracles. We know Jesus' disciples could preach and teach. But these individuals were clear. "Philip, we are not here for you. We want to see Jesus." Inasmuch as Philip seems not to understand this and he decides to tell Andrew, the hierarchy kicks in. He still doesn't do what has been asked. Fortunately, Andrew told Jesus. And it appears as if the words that come from Jesus and he starts speaking in a prophetic manner is as if an affirmation that says, when people know what they are looking for, then my work here is done. When people know that whatever they are going through, the snaky spaces, when you learn to say, "We are not here for you, folks. We are not here for anybody else. We wish to see Jesus." That means this space here where we preach from, that altar becomes about Jesus, because that's what people wish to see, not our performances, not how good we are with our theology, with whatever. This is key to what we are here about, to send people, direct people towards Jesus. So whenever anybody comes to you, don't advertise your minister. "We have such a wonderful minister these days." No, we wish to see Jesus. "We don't know how beautiful your church is, even if you are worshiping under a tree." "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Because it is him who then declares at the end of this passage that when I'm lifted up, I will draw all people to myself. People need to be drawn to Jesus, not to us as individuals, not to churches, not to buildings, but to Jesus. So whatever snaky spaces we find ourselves in, remember to do this like these Greeks. "Sir, we wish to see Jesus," because it is only him that we can deal with what's happening here. "Sir, say, oh dear sir, we wish to see Jesus." In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Say that we love.
As we come to the prayers of the church, just hold in mind two statements. The first is from Richard Foster, that intercession is a way of loving others. And then Saint Augustine says, prayer is to intercede for the well-being of others before God. And so as we begin our intercessions, George Buttrick recommends beginning with our enemies, which is surely one of the snaky spaces in our lives. So we pray now for those who we regard with fear or bitterness or contempt, those about whom we enjoy hearing bad news or spreading gossip, or about whom we are quick to believe the worst, whether it's individuals or organizations or groups of people. Pray for those whom we have hurt or offended or ignored. So we've confessed our sins. Now we pray for their well-being. And we say, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our leaders, both locally and nationally. We pray for the restoring of good governance, for the rule of law, for ethical citizenship, for respect and compassion amongst us, and a more just social order. And we pray for all health workers and administrators, not just those caring for the sick, but those in organising an efficient and fair vaccination programme. And we pray especially for clear, reliable information about the various vaccines, for protection against rumours and scaremongering. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And we pray for our church, that its members may truly be salt and light through words and deeds in our suffering land, and especially for the leadership of this church at the start of a new chapter in our lives. Give to our leaders here clear guidance and a unity of spirit as they shape the work and the worship and the witness of this branch of your church. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And finally, we pray for our families and our friends and our colleagues, all those with special needs or claims upon us. Let's name those that come to mind before God and allow his Spirit to make that prayer specific. Merciful Father, accept these our prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, who intercedes on our behalf. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. For us it becomes the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. For us it becomes the cup of salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
Worship and praise belong to you, maker of light and darkness. Your wisdom draws beauty from chaos, brings a harvest out of sorrow, calls out to those who have lost their way, and leads them safely home. God of grace and glory, you made us, you seek and find us. We are your own. In Christ your Son, enemies are reconciled, debts forgiven and strangers are made welcome. Your Spirit frees us to live as sons and daughters secure in your family. We, who by Christ's power seek to follow the way of the cross, sharing the joy of Christ's obedience, now offer you our praise with angels and archangels, and with the whole company of heaven, singing hymn of your unending glory. Glory and thanksgiving are yours, most loving and gracious God, for Jesus Christ, in whom the world is reconciled. He is the Lamb of God who takes away our sin and gathers us into the abundant new life of your forgiveness. Through Christ's dark struggle, death is swallowed up in victory. Christ, the firstborn, freely offered himself as the Passover Lamb. For the sins of the world, by his loving sacrifice, he institutes the reign of eternal light and abundant life. By his blood, by his wounds, we are healed. Before he was given up to suffering and death, at a meal recalling the night of Israel's Passover release, Jesus took bread, offered you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his friends, saying, "Take it, this is my body, it is broken for you. Do this to remember me." After supper, he took the cup. Again, he offered you thanks, gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that all sin may be forgiven. Do this to remember me." We now obey your Son's command. We recall Christ's passion and death. We celebrate Christ's resurrection. We look for the coming of Christ's kingdom. Made one with him, we offer you these gifts. With them we offer ourselves a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most loving Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon the bread and wine that we offer, overshadowed by his life-giving power. They may be the body and blood of your Son. By your grace, open our ears to hear you calling us home, arouse in our hearts the desire to return to you, and kindle within us the fire of your love that renews us for the service of Christ's kingdom. Help us to live and work to your praise and glory. Make us grow together in unity and love, until at your last creation is renewed and restored. Then bring us with Mary, the mother of our Lord, and all the hosts of heaven to our true eternal home, where we may praise you forever. Risen Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world without end. Amen. Friends, draw near and receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is gracious.
His mercy endures forever.
Almighty and eternal God, we thank you for feeding us in these holy mysteries with the body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for keeping us by your grace in the body of your Son, the company of all faithful people. Help us to persevere as living members of that holy fellowship, and to grow in love and obedience according to your will, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Father Almighty, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. In Jesus Christ, our Lord, send us out into the world in the power of the Holy Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among us and remain with us always. Amen. Let us live in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.
A banner that flies across this land, that all men might see the truth and know he is the way to heaven. We want to see Jesus lifted high. We want to see Jesus lifted high.